Hey guys, welcome back to my last episode for this season. As you can see, we have a small wandering horde issue. Just want to get them away from the spikes. Don't fall in. Rear few down there. So I just want to show you guys what I did before the horde comes. Just want their attention on me so they don't fall in the spikes and damage it. Man, the shotgun is powerful. It's not even at maximum strength. There's still one perk that I have to upgrade. And there's even still more coming in the background. So I actually did the spikes off camera because it took a while to actually repair and upgrade all of them. I only got enough steel, or managed enough steel, to get the one layer of spikes in intervals, as you can see the second layer. So unfortunately we don't have full strength spikes for this horde. Also, after this mini horde I just have to restart the game, because I just noticed that it's medium and it's this large a wandering horde. One more somewhere down here. Yeah. Okay, so as you can see, I have all the drawbridges up. Guys, admittedly, I had to use creative mode to fill this block over here, because all of these were steel and it still didn't take. And when I took steel blocks and placed it here, it took. But only on this one side. So yeah, unfortunately I had to do that, and then, as I said, I did all the spikes, made them all steel, and then, iron, and then the second one on the second layer, log spikes. Every second spike I made steel. So yeah, let's hope this ward goes well. I just quickly want to get inside. I haven't had time to do this ramp over here all the way around, so we'll do that next time, and then, yeah. Guys, I wanted to make this a full roof and then a wall in between, but I actually like this design that I have at the moment. So I'm actually thinking of keeping it just like this, only to have the entrance for mini bikes and that's it. But then again, I made this for no reason then. Also, I brought my mini bike to safety. And now we're ready for the horde. So I'm just quickly going to restart so I can set it to maximum and then we'll face the horde. I accidentally set it to high, and once I got through, it was already 10. So I had to go out again, set it to very high, and now it's way past 10, so they're going to be upon us. Okay, from which direction are they coming? Also, I haven't had time to dig the pits on that side. Where are they coming from? I actually greatly regret this pit, because you can't see the zombies coming on, so you don't know where they, which direction they're coming from. And at the moment, they're all dying on that side, they're not even coming close. I find it rather strange that they're falling straight down. Already my first pop. Okay, where is this guy? Both of them, damn. Okay, so that one exploded. I'm gonna try and loot these corpses as soon as I can. And I can't reach all of them. Let's quickly empty our inventory. Awesome, in the air. Oh, that was an awesome shot. Come on. There you are. Come on, get closer. I won't be able to loot you from there. It's gonna wreck all my spikes. The sniper rifle is my favorite gun, and in this enclosed space, it's extremely hard to use it. I can tell you this, the spikes are working. I just wish I built this thing on top of the surface. Come on, stop blocking each other. There are so many cops, but they keep sticking next to the wall. Ooh, come to Papa. Damn, my aiming is off today. What the hell was that? Looked like one of the corpses exploded. Yeah, come on, cop, where are you? It's a shame that none of the cops come closer, or very few do. Yes, come on, come on, come on, jump up. How the hell was he? How are they doing that? There's nothing for them to stand on. Should actually be using my shotgun since it's close to the max skill. Come on, stand up. I hate that glitch where they jump like that. I can't get a fix on it. Damn, now he's gonna explode. Or not. Lucky me. Come closer to me. All of them are stuck on that side. They're stuck behind my loot. And quite a few of those corpses are cop corpses. So I'm losing a lot of guns now. See, he just disappeared. I think he landed on top. I didn't even notice that my wellness is going down. I have to kill them all before they touch the quarter blocks, otherwise I don't get the loot. Come to me. Ooh, a purple shotty. Come on, hop that spike. Another bad thing about the setup is I can't see where all the zombies are at. By the time I get to them, the spikes have killed them. I'm actually destroying my spikes faster than they are. Just dropped a few more things off. I thought this dog got through, but it was the cop spit. I haven't seen any ferals yet. Come on, give me your goodies. It would be awesome if you could reach the max shotgun skill now. He didn't disappear, awesome. So all day that you see a cop come right up to you. Oh yeah, feral. I hope I don't destroy those corpses or the other zombies do, because I want to be able to loot them later. Another feral. Bullseye! Almost two and it seems to be settling down now. I just hope that when a cop vomits, he doesn't vomit away the untouched loot. What is that? It looked like he had a chair or something on him. Where are you? See, he's up there. That's what I was talking about the cops. They don't need to be down here to hit you. The cop just destroyed the feral body. Unfortunately, I didn't have time for that tunnel on the other side, so I'll have to climb into the pit to loot all the corpses. By the time I do the showcase video, it should be done. Unfortunately, it's not done now. Another cop. I can already hear the difference between the different zombies' runs. How the hell did he hit me as he was flying? Just drop a few more things off. Ooh, first chest full. I should actually repair my shotgun now. The damage is starting to get low. Damn, too far to loot. It's strange, I can loot the corpses from there, but not him. How the hell did that work? He was bobbing up and down and I didn't even aim for him. Rather, I aimed for him, but not his head. Where the hell did you come from? Guys, the trick with bodies disappearing like that is if you think it's a finishing shot, press E so long. And it opens him up even if his body disappears. That's if you press it fast enough. Another one to our right. How the hell did he get in here? Come on, come to me. There you go. I have to kill these cops fast, otherwise they destroy all my loot. Another feral. What are they doing up there? Bullseye! Where are we? Oh, it's down here. Yeah. shotgun skill is 4 levels away from the last skill, last perk. But I never in this series wasted points, but I think I'm gonna waste it in the last 4 shotgun skill points. So let's just quickly put these away. Not again, come on, how the hell do they get in here? That block's supposed to stop them. Usually you'd put a lip over, but it wasn't necessary since the blocks were placed wrong. Okay, let's quickly purchase those points. Shotgun, see, it's close to full, but I'd rather do this and we can get splattergun. Come on, copper. I love when they jump all the way close to you so you can loot them. This is awesome, it's almost a guaranteed dismemberment. Come on. Let's see if you can actually hit them. Why is it only now towards the end that I'm getting better with my aiming? I mean, 3 zombies in a row headshot. Almost 4 o'clock. Okay, so when are the zombies gonna stop? Okay, let's go see what goodies these zombies have brought us. I'm gonna put these in here to make some space. I also don't need my shotgun ammo for now, since I have my shotgun level to max. And let's just do this so we can make some space for that ammo. We can do this, throw this one away, put that up there. Okay, let's go see what we got. Now I should actually take my axe with, but we're not going to clean up now, so there's no need for that. I want to fall on one of the corpses so it breaks my fall a bit. Oh, come on. How are you still alive? Dead. Okay, let's quickly go loot them before all the loot disappears. Fall on here. I'm only going to keep the cool stuff. All the boring stuff I'll either scrap or throw away. What I want to do now is off camera mine a bit for a few days and then upgrade this whole place to steel. Then in between that, I'll decide whether I want a wall or not in between this and the base. And if I do want a wall, I'll just quickly do that, upgrade the base to steel, and then I'll show off the base to you guys. Because I still need to show you all the rooms. Note to self, you cannot jump on those corpses on the small spikes. I thought you could. That was too close. Ooh, my leather. It's a good thing I have that one. 91. All my skills are very high except for my leather. My leather is so close to max. I actually want to show you guys those skills as well. Just need to get to the other side quickly. Come on. I don't want to die now. After the ward. I'm just glad we actually survived this horde. I had my doubts because we can't see where the zombies come from. Okay, and that seems to be all. I think this is the only area they hit. It took out most of the small spikes and then also did a little bit of damage over here. But it was only because I couldn't see them coming. Let's see why all the spikes are gone up to there. Oh no, the spikes are not gone. It's just a blind man. As you remember, this is still part of this block, so the only spikes that are gone are these over here. So this base actually held up quite well, considering that we weren't able to make all of the spikes steel. So I'm actually quite proud of this base now. Anyways, so like I said, I'm gonna repair all of this, the spikes and everything. I'm gonna dig a tunnel underneath on all four sides to make the room over there. Guys, as soon as that room's up, we'll be able to go under and then loot all the corpses from this side. It's just gonna be a little hassle replacing all those spikes. So I might still need to come down now and then for that. But that's also the big problem with this build we have over here. I was shooting the zombies from behind there. Just look at all the damage I did to the wall. They weren't hitting the wall. I was hitting the wall with a shotgun. So that's the biggest setback from having a base underground. Not underground, just sunken into the ground. You do your own damage to your own walls. So I think next build I do, I will definitely be up above ground. I'll never do a build underneath ground again. At least where I face the zombies. The build can be underneath. Like for example, when I did with the farm a few Let's Plays back, where the farm's on top and then underneath is the base. Then you can still face the zombies on top. So I also finished that up there. So that looks pretty cool. Where's the tree? I do not see the tree. Did they destroy that now? Where the hell's my tree? Oh, seriously. My tree is gone. That sucks. They didn't destroy any of the glass, so how the hell did the tree disappear? Must be a bug, because I know I didn't destroy it. Anyway, so yeah, I'm gonna try and make the whole base steel. Replant that tree to make it look nice again. Finish the garden, and then finish this wall and roof. If you guys liked this episode, please leave a like and share with your friends. If you have any comments or feedback regarding this episode or future builds, please let me know down below. And if you guys are new to this channel, please remember to subscribe for more of this content. See you guys next time.